Mount Everest ain't got shit on me, 'cause I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world. Yeah. March Dubai ain't got shit on me. You can touch the sky, but you ain't got shit on me, 'cause I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world. Yeah.
Miles walked in 17 days. That is what it took for Andrew and I to accomplish our goal of harvesting a mature Roosevelt bull with a bow. As time went on, it took a toll on our bodies. 10 days of chasing elk. Our worlds had been crushed, and we thought all hope was lost. We lost access to the property we scouted and studied multiple times in the off season. I began to question myself and wondered if it was impossible to kill one of these animals with my bow. Instead of calling it quits and heading home to our families, we persevered and we decided to take a day to recover and get ready for the struggle of finding new hunting grounds and learning new land. We discovered an area that was very densely populated with elk and knew our dreams of killing our white whale would come true.
It's a bull we've been chasing for 7 or 8 hunts. is going to be incredibly difficult.
You should
go down there.
Did he just chase that cow?
Yeah. Jackfurs.
On the right side?
Yeah, on the right side of the road.
Because I thought I saw a bull chase a cow off to the left side.
Oh yeah, and then he wrapped back up and around.
Did you get the shot uphill?
Yeah. Oh, you thumped him.
Did you see the second one too?
I
cow called him and he sprinted at me.
Yeah.
And I f***ing drilled him, bro.
Dude, that was incredible.
That was like 3 hours. He's dead, dude. I watched him through our range finding. Like, he stood up and I cow called him again. And then he sat down, he put his head on the ground and just went.
Yeah, he's he is.
Oh my god.
Fourth attempt at killing this bull. And we got him.
Oh my god. Dude.
Wow.
Hold on, let me show. Dude.
That is something. Dude, Austin, holy crap.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5x5, baby. What?
He's, look at his body.
The amount of calories and energy that we exerted chasing this bull since the season started is just insane. Oh, wow. He's big. Wow. It's nice, Rosie. Well.
Where did my... Oh, this one.
All right, we got to get to work. All right. We're all quartered up. Gonna leave this meat in the shade and try and get all the rest down into the low ground where a creek is and hang it in a tree and start making it back to the truck. What do you think, like, distance-wise? 4 or 5 miles?
3 miles to the truck. Look at that muzzy.
Yep. Damn. 3 miles? It's more than that, isn't it?
It's like 4.
Yeah. Either way. Got our first load down into the bottom. Nice and cool. But we still got a hell of a ways to go. We just walked it straight out of the clear cut down into that drainage I had earlier. But we're going to hang it over this log and empty our packs out. Leave everything here and bring all the quarters down, hang them on the log, and then pack up all of our stuff with some meat, make one trip out, go get a cart, come back down into this drainage and come back out to the road, take the quarters up, put it on the cart and head out. So it's a lot of work. We're getting after it, trying to get the majority of this done before it gets dark, but it's probably not gonna happen. We got 3.5 hours before it gets dark, so yeah. All right, Austin, how you feeling?
Good.
Hopefully good.
I'm stoked. Can't believe it happened. First bull.
How many days were we hunting?
17 or 18 days of hunting.
Total.
And then maybe close to 200 miles now.
Yeah, after this pack out trip, yeah. We'll go over the logistics of it soon.